So the story with my ex was I was 17 when that happened. We dated for about a year and some drama happened, like crazy shit. Like she hacked into my emails, monitoring me and then violating me. My partner at the time, helped me communicate and just solve the problem. And then I just left it. Years later, I totally felt like I wanted to be a better person and I just wanted to show that I have moved on and I'm okay and I hope you are too, basically. So on the day of her birthday, I messaged and I was like, "Hey, happy birthday. I hope everything is good." And then I got an email back and it was basically like, "So sorry she died." And then I'm just like, and then years later, actually a month ago, I'm now 28, and here she is back from the dead, impersonating me, and I am just shocked. I am really shocked because it's a decade later, and I'm just really disappointed, but it was a really big lesson for me to go through. At first, I was just like, "Oh my God, what am I to do?" You know? And honestly, that's why I had this silence from social media because I was just like really put off by the whole thing, and I was just like, "What am I really? Like, what did I do so wrong that, my first love would do this?" And that made me really think about myself, you know? I felt like I mustn't be a good person. I don't understand. And then eventually I found out that, wait, I'm here always blaming myself. But the truth is, there is two stories in a relationship or in any relationship. There is more than one perspective. And whatever she's going through right now, I guess that's just her reflection and her pain, and she must be going through something pretty bad to do that. This is my most shameful thing that I've done in my life, in my experience of life. And the fact that I know this will hold me back if I didn't face it. If and what good is it for me to hide this truth that is a big part of me, is a big part of a lesson for me, a life lesson that, I should not like do such things no matter how much I love and no matter how threatened I feel towards someone leaving me. I should not do this in order to respect myself. And I'm sharing this now for anyone out there, men, women who are being catfish, and is going through such violation. I want you just to know that it's okay. Just shit happens. Come out with it. Move on. And that's it. And yeah, like I really want to say this so then I can just let that go. I mean, that's I guess that's my intensity of love and my intensity of being a friend is I want to be truthful right from the beginning. Give you my darkest secrets and give you my worst before I could give you my best. I know it's a bit, that's how I just know how to be. I'm sharing you all this story because I want to be a person that is free and I do not want anyone to hold any sort of power over me in the sense of like holding such photos as threats. And yo, she does not know I've been running around nude in festivals. I am all for nudity and we should free the nipples. Why can guys be topless at beaches and women can't? I want an even tan. I don't like the triangle over my boobs, to be honest. Hey, I am not a perfect person and I wanna just own up to my experiences, this has been such a traumatic experience, but not really at the same time, because I'm just this is not gonna stop me from flying. I am gonna be free, and the only way I can be free is me admitting to all my dark sides. And don't do moon things, yo. Notice my lessons. Okay, so let's move on to a lighter topic now, okay? So I'm a really, really lovey-dovey person. I'm so fucking lovey-dovey and I really like talking, but the thing about me is I am a social awkward. Is that even a word? I don't know. Right now, I am playing with reality. I have hit rock bottom. I left my job and I decided I wanted to become a YouTuber, but it took me a whole year. A whole some sort of content. But I did go on a year of this adventure in self-discovery, and that has brought me to where I am now. When I lived in Sydney, had a good job, was doing okay, just surviving, independently and showing my family that I could do this. And but one day I kind of woke up and I was I am so not happy. I got this nice apartment, I got this pretty car, but I feel like I'm drowning. I'm drowning into this cycle of work. And I was just really, what's happening? What's the point of me? I'm not having fun at all. So last year, February, is when I wanted to start YouTubing, and I thought coming back home would be a good opportunity for me just to focus on my YouTubing. And I really tried. I made one or two videos. My car is not so big, so I don't know if I could fit everything. I also have a couch to transport. It's crazy. And I forgot. Noodle has things too that I haven't packed. Right, Noodle? You have a lot of things. What's up? You know what else I've discovered about myself while I was packing?
Sun goes down, I need my power nap again. Take me where I
shouldn't hide. It's kind of like a creepy feeling when you walk around such places by yourself. I mean, I'm pretty close to the highway, but still. It's like when you look in the woods behind me over here, it's just like, I guess your mind kind of plays tricks on you sometimes. It makes you think is there someone there? But it's just actually a tree, hopefully. Okay, I just scared myself. No, let's get back to the car. Come on. I have an idea. While I was driving, I was thinking it would be so much fun for me to make videos about Australia to show you all that is watching what it's like here, and maybe when you come one day, you know what to see and what to do. How does that sound? Let me know on the comments below.
I will start driving now. Let's go to somewhere fun. If I got nothing to lose, I wanna see what is on the other side. If I got nothing to lose, I'll have it all I'm in. There'll be ups and downs, highs and...
Boop. Boop. Boop, 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 boop.
I was so tired, I took a nap, and I had this really crazy experience. Like, you know, I wanted to wake up, but I couldn't, but I was consciously aware where I was and what I was doing. And for some reason, I saw a spiritual me move, but my body couldn't move, but yet that other me was moving. And it took me so... I thought I was going to die. I thought I was going to be stuck like that. Was that a lucid dream? I don't know. But it was creepy.
So. Anyway. I'm basically at another rest stop. It's night again. Driving to Sydney to Melbourne. I mean, from Sydney to Melbourne. It should only take me around 9 hours. But somehow I've taken 2 days. And you know why? I'm freaking out. I'm freaking out that I'm thinking if it's a good idea to move back, because I've been in Sydney for 8 years. I love how outdoorsy, adventurous this city is. And then Melbourne is more like, you know, a chill city where there's just some buildings. National parks is quite far away. And the fact is, when I left home, as I mentioned earlier, I basically ran away from home. And now, you see, like, I didn't run away because my family was bad to me or anything. I ran away because I wasn't comfortable there, you know? My friendship was bad, my love life was bad. I didn't feel like I was understood in my family, and then so I left home. And then it was supposed to be a holiday, and then I ended up staying there for 8 years. And now I'm nervous to head back. Even though I've been back visiting in between these 8 years, I'm not living there. The idea of me living there now, it really freaks me out. Like, really. I don't know what to do. Noodle. Noodle just follows me wherever I go. So, I can't really ask her what we should do. Yay! We're finally here, and I had like a breakdown, I guess, because, you know, I just feel so bad, and maybe I left too much unfinished business here, and I guess this is an opportunity for me to overcome that all.
And I felt I had to meet so many of my fears in a really short time. And that was a big punch in the face. And I sunk into depression and I got really sick. And then I was just like, I really need to change things up. I need to keep fighting. I need to keep going. And I need to just do what I do best, you know, just be. And so here I am now. I have to add, I will disappear for about a week or two because I am rock bottom right now, and I feel I need to run off into Mother Nature and just get my shit together and then come back with new, improved, and of light and positivity. Yeah, I just want to bring smiles. And this will be really exciting because I plan on going on a full detox and just water. Nothing but water. And yeah, I will bring my devices and make a short little documentary, but I must add that's gonna be tricky because battery runs out. And so I really have to utilize myself, you know, and I feel like I'm really good at that. So I think it'll be okay. Thank you for watching and thank you for all the support, all the love. I will update you guys soon about my process and more things, more random things. Just, I'll try to pick up a funny one next one.